The Harrier has been in operational service with the Royal Air Force since early 1969. This is number one squadron, one of two units based in Britain. A further three squadrons are based in Germany. All the Harrier squadrons are assigned to NATO and operate from northern Norway down to the eastern Mediterranean. Thank you.
first scramble, you're basically excited. You're actually going off to do the job that you've been trained to do to the most extent you ever will in peacetime. And excitement's probably the biggest emotion.
It's all on automatic until you're airborne, really. It's, as I say, the adrenaline is very high. You get out there, you start the transit, and then you start wondering what you're going to come up against, because you don't know what you're going to see until you intercept it.
It's a long time to wait around and with nothing actually happening. Do you ever, at the back of your mind, hope that something will happen?
Yes. Yes, I think we do, but then it's not as if we're waiting for the onset of war. We're looking for light aircraft. Everybody likes to have a scramble. We'll get a scramble message from our controllers. We'll then get launched from Wildenrath. We'll get cleared straight through the airways. We'll head east, and we'll go there almost supersonic.
One unidentified aircraft coming away North Cape at the moment. Alert, Southern QRA.
QRA, quick reaction alert. Five times a week, on average, an RAF fighter is scrambled on a quick reaction alert. Mission, to intercept and escort any unidentified aircraft which threatens our airspace.
03, cockpit readiness.
Scramble, scramble, scramble.
03, scrambling.
I'm looking level on radar. Nothing yet.
Starboard 360. Target 015 at 30,000.
03, roger.
03, an airborne early warning aircraft in your sector is monitoring the situation.
03, roger.
I think I got in contact at 10 right level.
Intercept and identify.
180.
Shadow.
03, shadowing.
Target is turning away. You're clear to return to base.
03, returning to base.
Roger, 03.
QRA, quick reaction. We'll be right back.
Mach 1, just below the speed of sound, at some 60,000 feet. Missiles began to acquire the range and lethality to make that a dangerous game. Vulcan came back with a low-level range supporting NATO.
Thank you.